Hello. I like make today a sombrero cake. So what we need for this recipe? We need 3 boxes of butter cake mixes. So what we do is we mix 1 cake mix box according to instruction on back of box and bake it in a square baking pan. It's 20 by 28 inch by 8 inch. So we get a square cake. This cake we will use to build middle of sombrero. So with this cake, once it's baked and completely cooled down, simply level just like that and set aside. Once all cake is leveled, we set aside. So for the main cake, we need 2 butter cake mix boxes. So you can use vanilla sponges also, or use your favorite recipe, just double it simply. So, and for the main cake, which is our head, will be use widest, whatever you have available at home, type of glass heat proof bowl. For example, you can use even this one, for example, or if you have something like a donut ring, would be okay as well. You just build up middle. So I use simply this type of heat proof bowl. This one particular 24 centimeter in diameter in a base, which is 9.5 inch. I think this is actually tart type of pan, or you know, glass bowl, and basically I just use simply this one. So I mix 2 butter cake mixes all together, and just simply what you do is place 2 layers of baking paper just around, just on the sides, to mix build sides, and just pour and simply bake for about 40 minutes, or according instruction on your cake mix box. So once it's baked, I leave for about 10-15 minutes in the bowl before I place onto wire rack to cool completely down. So once it's completely cooled, what we do is now we simply take we level top of cake with serrated knife. Just make sure it's nice and flat. And what we do is next, we take round cookie cutter, this one 8 centimeters, all inches and ounces will be in description box, please do have a look. Measure where is middle, place on the middle, and just simply place, just leave it as it is, because this is will our middle of a cake we will build. So right now what we do is just leave it this cookie cutter, and we simply leave border as it is, and we just remove the middle part, just this one. We just keep it this one, we remove it later. Once we trim it to make a shape of sombrero, as you can see, you can slightly trim it a little bit, a base of a cake also, if you need to do so, and it just simply goes to middle, which is we left middle inside of our cookie cutter. So we remove cookie cutter and base of the middle of head already done. So we use same cookie cutter to cut out 2-3 rounds and place on top of each other. That will build up our middle of the cake. So on this moment we take just extra 2 and it will probably enough. Make sure it's nice and straight also. And what we do is use a buttercream or simply use vanilla frosting. So with the plain buttercream or frosting, what we do is we add a yellow gel food coloring, whatever available in your country. You can use the Wilton or Americola yellow gel food coloring. I have this similar sort of type here, and we just mix it to create yellow color of sombrero head. And place a small amount of vanilla frosting or buttercream in separate plate and tint it with a red gel food coloring to create red color buttercream. This one particular will be used for decorations. So we got color of yellow buttercream, something like that. So what we do is next, we simply join these parts and sandwich with buttercream. And then we can trim it. Once we trim it a little bit top of middle part of head, that's how it looks like. Now it doesn't require that much trimming. So what we do is next, we simply apply yellow tinted buttercream, just in a thin layer around cake and on middle as well. Once apply first layer of buttercream, place in the freezer for about 30 minutes to seal the crumbs. Take out a cake from freezer. It should be really, really hard. And apply second layer of buttercream. Once it's all done, make sure it's nice and neat. So use different color of the fondant and roll out into long strips. Measure up about 1 centimeter width and green one slightly wider. It's up to you to choose design of sombrero you really, really like. And once you basically measure up, cut out, simply attach those colors of fondant. Thank you. next step is place the your buttercream, which is you done tinted with red gel food coloring, into a piping bag fitted with a small round nozzle. It's about a tip 4. So take just a toothpick and simply create a design on top. And pipe with your radar. Use a blue fondant or leftover of a buttercream. You can tint it into blue color using royal blue gel food coloring. But if you have some of the blue fondant, just simply roll into small even balls, slightly squash them, and simply attach for decoration. Then roll out red color fondant and just have about half a centimeter width, a few strips, to make sure we're able to attach in front of cake. And the last part of decoration is we need use the a little bit left over of our red tinted buttercream, and I use this one. This is chocolate balls. It's called Choc Orange Jaffas. It's sort of like just a simply red chocolate balls. If you like, you can use gum balls. They similar shape like that. If you like to use those, or just simply use whatever available similar in your country. So what we do is we simply pipe red frosting, sort of like a line, and on the end we pipe slightly little bit more. That's where we attach our chocolate ball, right on the end. So once we finish all the decorations, as you can see, our sombrero hat is ready. I hope you like this very simple creation for the cake. Thank you very much for your time with me today. You can of course use your own design or just simply print a design from internet, which is you really like it. Everything will be in the description box. Thank you very much for your time with me today. Until next time, goodbye.